Hello friends, once again, welcome to Tech With Us and in the video tutorial series on embedded system. Friends, there are many topics in C language that often confuses developers. But I personally believe the usage of static keyword, which seems to be one of the most common one. And it become more challenging when it actually comes to the code review and debugging the bug. So in this video, I try to cover all possible usage and application of static keyword in C language with their relevant examples. So I hope at the end of this video, you will be having the complete information which will be helpful at your workstation. So let's start. Static is a storage class specifier that can be applied to an object of any data type. It controls both lifetime and visibility of that object. Static tells the compiler to make the variable or function limited in scope while allowing it to persist throughout the life of the program. So to make it more clear, let's talk about various storage classes. A variable declared within a function is by default an automatic or local variable, which are created and stored on the stack memory and destroyed when the function returns. Variable declared with register specifier has similar lifetime and scope as automatic, but the storage will be the CPU internal register. Register specifier are useful for the variable which needs faster access, as accessing CPU register will be much faster compared to the stack memory. The external storage class specifier is little different. It means declare without defining. It provides only the declaration and indicates the compiler that the object has been defined elsewhere. All global variables by default has external storage class. The effect of an object definition prefixed with static keyword is completely context dependent. A local static variable is visible to only the function where it is defined, but has lifetime throughout the program. And a global static variable can be accessed by any function within the same module or file and has lifetime throughout the program. This feature makes static object very unique, and there can be three primary usage for the static keyword. It can be used as a local variable within a function and a global variable within a module or a function within a module. State machine implementation is one of the most common application of local static variable. As shown in this example, state variable is the static local variable which will be defined at the time of first call to the function state machine and will be initialized to zero. The value of static variable will be retained across multiple function calls. So by changing the value, it can execute different code units. The other major application of static variable can be found as event counter, which will count the positive or negative event across multiple function calls. Defining a variable within the global scope of a module implicitly declares the variable as extern. But to avoid unauthorized access from other module, it should be explicitly declared with static keyword. As shown in this example, temperature is going to be used by various functions of temperature module. So in this case, it makes sense to hide it from other modules by making it static. By default, functions are also implicitly declared as external. But in our temperature module example, we know that reading temperature is module internal responsibility and should not be visible outside the module. So we can make this function local by using static. But yes, few functions like getTemperature can be external with other application modules. So in summary, static keyword has many uses. As a developer, by using static, you can strictly control how a variable can be accessed, which is considered good programming practice. So please share your feedback on this video and don't forget to subscribe my channel for all upcoming updates. Thanks for watching. Hope you like it.